This week on Homie the Van, we're going to show you how to save like half your costs on big, long kitchen drawer pull-outs.
Yeah.
They're extremely expensive for the actual pull-outs on Amazon. So we sort of stole this idea from somebody else, and we're going to send it to you.
And we're also working on finishing our storage compartments under the bed.
And then when we finish that, we're going to finish off
our closet, which we started but haven't finished.
Alright, today's the day. Today's the day we turn our boxes into drawers. But first I gotta get rid of this mess. Got our half-ass tidy. Time to work on the van. Then again, I couldn't have, 'cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down. Here I am with our completed storage compartments. What we did to complete them today was install this bulkhead on the passenger side. So in this compartment will be our water reservoir, and in this compartment will be our battery box.
Should be good.
So right now we're working on our table and our closet doors. We're going to be putting a drop-down table on the front and two closet doors on each side.
We bought a 96-inch pine project board. And we're going to cut it into our drawer faces and our closet doors. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile it. The whole day.
Josh is now cutting our table, which I'm in the process of wood burning. So we finally finished our closet. We did a cupboard door here and a cupboard door here. And then this will be our drop down table, which I'm currently working on wood burning. So there'll be hinges here and a knob up here, and you'll just drop it down and have it install the table.
Actually looks super cool.
There you go.
We're going to be putting our big topper on here to cover up our top of our doors. And everywhere else we have something we can screw down into. But on this edge, we don't. So I cut this perfectly straight piece of half-inch plywood. And it's going here to the glue and screw our topper to. So here's the end-all, be-all discussion of our improvised budget drawer rail systems. So, started out, we picked up these. These little guys are skateboard roller bearings. We got 20 of them on Amazon for 12 bucks. And a ton of weight, and they'll pretty much roll forever in this application. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna mount up these rails, and these will mount up inside our van. Just the way that everything worked out for us. And then we're gonna mount our wheels through our drawers. And then when they roll out, it's gonna look like this. Nice. And we're gonna drill quarter inch holes through our drawers. And then I've just got some nice quarter inch flat washers to sandwich the board into. Just a little 3/16 nut as a spacer. And rock and roll.
we've got our roller bearings installed, we're going to try to install them now, just to make sure, and then we're going to do our other drawer.
So, this was the way we decided to do our drawer rails. You can see how our little skateboard roller bearings work here. So you just got the ones on the top to carry the weight, and then the one underneath wedges it down so that when it's at full pull, it's sturdy. And actually, as you can see, plenty sturdy to work on or do whatever you want, right? So our rails for our drawers, in order to make them more or less level, we kind of came up above the level of our uprights. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna get 1x2s and we're gonna make a nice, level, sturdy frame and put it on top of everything. But we can't do our bed topper for now because our drawers are too high.
So there you have it. Fruits of our labor for the weekend. Closet doors. And kitchen drawers. Our closet face with doors. Middle part's out getting wood burned by Michelle right now. So hopefully you like what we're doing. Like and subscribe to our channel. Comments or questions. We'd love to hear from you. And tune in next week to see what we're up to then. Bye.